From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Claudia Edwards, the woman at the center of a rape allegation against immigration officer Norman Bastian, was eulogized yesterday after dying of COVID-19. Edwards died at the Princess Margaret Hospital last month, one day after giving birth to her fourth child. She was 35 years old. A Jamaican national, Edwards accused Mr. Bastian of raping her twice on December 15th and December 16th, 2014, after she was arrested on suspicion of exotic dancing and breaching immigration laws. Pick up a copy of today's Tribune for more on this story. Police removed a man's partially decomposed body from the New Providence landfill yesterday in what Assistant Superintendent of Police Audley Peters said appears to be a suspicious death. ASP Peters said autopsy results will show whether foul play was involved or not. He said a landfill employee found the body in a well when he went to examine the hole, which was used by the landfill to help battle fires when they needed water. ASP Peters said it appeared the man's body was decomposing for more than 24 hours, and the man appeared to be in his late 30s or early 40s. Officers were made aware of the matter shortly before 2 p.m. yesterday. National Security Minister Marvin Dames said fewer COVID-19 restrictions are likely a factor, but not a significant one, in the uptick in murders this year. There have been multiple killings in just the past week, including two on Thursday and another on Friday night. Compared with last year, murders and armed robberies have increased by more than 50 and 40%. In January, Police Commissioner Paul Roll credited last year's 16% reduction in murder to the efforts of law enforcement, not the significant lockdowns and restrictions on movement implemented to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Residents and business establishments in the northern and central areas of New Providence are advised that sightings of the invasive cane toad have been reported in nearby communities. It must be noted that the handling of cane toads with bare hands should be discouraged, as the venom produced from these animals is an irritant to the skin. Ingestion of that venom is also toxic to humans and deadly to pets. Assistance is needed by the public to limit the spread of these animals by removing sitting water sources and forming a chemical barrier around properties and within landscapes. This chemical barrier can be created by using a spray solution composed of 2 cups of Dettol or Savlon to 1 cup water. Officials said that early mornings and late evenings are the best time to spray that solution. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, Pennsylvania's highest court threw out Bill Cosby's sexual assault conviction and opened the way for his immediate release from prison today in a stunning reversal of fortune for the comedian, once known as America's Dad, ruling that the prosecutor who brought the case was bound by his predecessor's agreement not to charge Cosby. Cosby, 83, has served more than 2 years of a 3 to 10 year sentence after being found guilty of drugging and violating Temple University sports administrator Andrea Constant at his suburban Philadelphia home in 2004. He was the first celebrity tried and convicted in the Me Too era. Cosby was arrested in 2015 when a district attorney armed with newly unsealed evidence, the comic's damaging deposition testimony in a lawsuit brought by Constant, brought charges against him days before the 12-year statute of limitations ran out. 4 more bodies have been found in the rubble of a collapsed Florida condo tower, a fire official said today, raising the death toll in the disaster to 16 people. Miami-Dade Assistant Fire Chief Raid Jadala told family members at a morning briefing that rescuers found the bodies Tuesday night. He said relatives have not yet been identified. In addition to the 4 bodies, crews also found other human remains. Rescuers were able to build a ramp for a crane to reach areas at the top of the pile they had not been able to access before. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. A moist and unstable layer over the Bahamas will continue to enhance shower activity through tonight. Meanwhile, high-pressure ridging continues to maintain moderate to locally fresh winds. Boaters and residents should remain vigilant for possible waterspout or tornadic activity. Beachgoers in the central Bahamas should exercise caution due to the threat of rip currents along east and south coast beaches. There is a high risk of localized flooding in low-lying or flood-prone flood-prone areas during heavy or prolonged rainfall periods. The public is also advised to remain hydrated due to triple-digit heat indices. For all areas, it'll be variably cloudy, very warm, and a bit breezy to breezy conditions with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms through tonight. Small craft caution remains in effect in the southeast Bahamas. Gusty winds and higher seas and heavy showers and thunderstorms. Winds east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots, but occasionally gusty in the northwest and the central Bahamas. East to southeast at 15 to 20 knots, but higher gusts in the southeast Bahamas. Seas 2 to 4 feet in the northwest and central Bahamas, 4 to 6 feet over the ocean in the southeast Bahamas. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees, with a heat index of 101, with an overnight low temperature of 72. The sun will set this afternoon at 8:02 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:24. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper, now on the streets. Or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.